you know, as this is all happening and Danny's losing, blowing her 3-dragon lead before our eyes, Tyrion and Varys are scheming.
Yeah, just the talk. Varys finally, you know, sort of approaches Tyrion with this idea that, you know, maybe Daenerys isn't the one that we were waiting for that can come in through and save us.
Which I do feel like maybe they came to that conclusion a little hastily still. Mm-hmm. Like, there have been hints, but like, damn, she, you know, she hasn't done anything yet. You're being a little preemptive, but I don't know. Also, though, Varys, I just feel like he needs to be in Mean Girls. Like, I just love, like, it's not a secret anymore. That's just information. Yeah. Like, that just sounds like...
That was an amazing line.
Yeah.
But in this scene, you know, it's just like, I could actually understand doubting Daenerys. Like, you can see it on them.
You can see it on her face,
like,
too.
And you can see it in Varys and Tyrion. But the fact that they want to throw it to Jon, Jon's my boy. I've always supported Jon. In this whole Game of Thrones story, however, like, he isn't the one to rule. Like, he isn't the one that's better than Daenerys.
He kind of has had really bad ideas and bad strategies, like, the whole time.
Have you seen him, like, just be failing, like, at these...
Well, and, you know, he's very Ned-like and like, oh, I'm just gonna do what I think is honorable, whether it's a good idea or not. Like, nope, that's not how the throne works.
You're nobly following this path. Like, even in this episode, like, no, we should go because we've been asked. Like, we're marching to the
And it's a bad idea.
Like,
you know, who maybe would have seen...
Listen to your advisors.
Yeah, maybe would have seen a fleet of scorpions staring at them had they been rested. Dragons. Dragons would have. So, yeah, and that brings us to the conclusion, which... Missandei! Oh.
Well, I thought it was kind of... lucky that they took down a ship and so happened to, like, Lynch is, like, rowing by. I'm like, that one. We want that one. Pull her out. Leave everybody else here. And, like,
but Grey Worm tells her to go down.
Yeah,
she
would have
been escaping late.
Like,
if she was down below, because he jumps off as soon as it gets, like, they start blowing holes in it. And I don't know.
I feel like there would have been, like, Unsullied all over the place.
She would have been one of the last ones off, though, because Grey Worm jumps off right away.
Mm-hmm. Well, she could have also been in that little skiff, that little boat.
Told her to go down below. Which meant she, as it was, like, sinking, she would have had to come back up. Yeah, because they were shooting at the top.
Either
That's where she was.
I still was like, that seems very unlikely.
It's not my worst plot hole I've ever heard of in this show. Whatever, you know. But, and, you know, Euron, I felt like they probably wanted to take someone on purpose. But, yeah, it is a lucky break. I totally thought Grey Worm was going to die in the show. I never thought Missandei on our death predictions. So was crazy.
She was supposed to survive and Grey Worm is supposed to go.
Oh, and speaking of that scene, though, right before we get to the end, Tyrion obviously just tries to go talk Cersei down because, you know, he's trying to save the city and what he thinks is his sister's baby because he's always loved his nieces and nephews and he's just a generally honorable dude.
And I think his sister too. Like, I'm still, you know, I fully believe that Tyrion is a complex character, even though Cersei really does want him dead. Like, that's still his sister, and I still think that there's those complicated emotions that arise in him, you know, like...
Well, and that's why he wants to save her life. Like, he offers her life to, like, get her off.
I don't think it's people, you know, I guess I've heard criticisms, you know, like that was stupid of him, or, you know, this wasn't a smart decision.
Like, I mean, he had to try. It didn't really make a difference. Missandei was going to die either way, so...
Like... That didn't make anything worse. You know, if anything, like, he might have been successful in, like, saving Missandei, maybe giving them some more time to negotiate or something, but...
And he might have really unwittingly blew a division between her and her allies because he lets it drop that he knows she's pregnant, which if Euron has any sense, which I'm not sure he does, then he might be figuring out how the fuck could Tyrion know that.
Right.
Because she literally just told him that she was pregnant with his baby.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, he might need to be thinking about that one kind of hard. Like, wait a second.
Right.
I almost wish he would have just dropped the, like, Jaime's baby. Although, I'm not sure Euron really cares that much. I don't know. I don't understand him as a character at all.
He's just a sad little pirate man that needs to die next episode.
Hopefully very soon. I know. I really don't like that he's one of the last characters. I'm like, get him out of here.
He's the worst. Please leave.
Exit left. No, though, Miss Sandy, though, she gets to say her last word, and Dracarys. I was like, you are such a badass.
Yeah.
Like, it was, burn this shit down.
I do wish that she would have, you know, like, tried to take Cersei down with her, since they're right both there at the edge. But a second consolation prize is, you know, just her defiant, like, last words.
Her being like, yeah, burn it.
Yeah. Like, you get no more, like... no more breaks from us. Like, you're all dying.
No. And you, fire. And then, you know, the last scene is just Dany's face where she just, you know, that's a lot of grief. One more of her people is gone. One of the very few people who are absolutely loyal to her.
Yeah.
Which I think really she just has Grey Worm.
Yeah.
That's it. Mm-hmm. Jorah and Missandei gone. That leaves Grey Worm because we've already seen that Tyrion's allegiance is wavering.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, and I guess Drogon. That's all.
The one dragon.
Yeah, the one dragon we have left. And obviously, honestly, Grey Worm. I saw that there was, like, an amazing gif that was, like, from The Office when they're pointing finger guns at each other in a circle. And it's, like, Arya, Grey Worm, and Dany fighting over who gets to kill Cersei. Because now Grey Worm's just going to, like, run in there by himself, I feel like.
Oh, I think there's some more, there should be some more people in that little circle, but...
Well, we've already said what we think about Jamie, but there was, yeah. Grey Worm is pissed. Took away the only happiness he was ever going to have. And I, at least as a consolation prize, can't wait to see him to do really badass things next episode.
Oh, yeah. I'm really looking forward to, like, his, like, just vengeance, like, coming through.
Oh, my God.
Like, 'cause he's... you know, a trained soldier. He's got that, like, patience and
yeah, he seems like a pretty good military mind. Like, so, just,
but I don't know. Now he's angry, and I don't want to see what he does when he's angry.
I'm not sure he's gonna make it out though. Now I feel like he's gonna throw everything at it.
No, and like he said,
he's just gonna want vengeance.
To Missandei, like a couple of episodes ago, you know, after this war's over, there's not really a place for him there, he feels like. So why not?
Well, the place was on the beach with Missandei, but we'll see. But that was the episode. Thanks for listening.
Ciao.